front. Yes, it will go. Trust me.
As you might expect, a fairly restrained welcome to the ring for the underdog, Sergio Daniel Marani of Argentina, 28 years old, ranked number 8 in the world by the World Boxing Council. Andrews, the world champion, a homecoming. He hasn't fought in Britain for 4 years. He hasn't been in this ring at the Albert Hall since 1978.
Our gentlemen, please. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please be upstanding and show respect for both national anthems.
Gentlemen,
please. This, ladies and gentlemen, is the main event of the evening. National Promotions present a light heavyweight contest of 12 3-minute rounds at 12 stone 6 pounds for the WBC Light Heavyweight Championship of the World. Presenting and introducing in this corner, ladies and gentlemen, from Argentina, the challenger, Sergio Marani. And from Hackney, ladies and gentlemen, the light heavyweight champion of the world, Dennis Andrews. At the weigh-in today, Marani scaled 12 stones 5.5 pounds, Andrews 12 stones 5.25 pounds. The officials for this contest, appointed by the World Boxing Council, judges Arsène Klopp of Luxembourg, Newton Campos from Brazil, Sid Rubenstein from the USA, the World Boxing Council representative from France, Mr. Bernard Restu, the referee is Mr. Franz Marti of Switzerland, and the timekeeper, Mr. Jeff Williams of England.
So Franz Marti of Switzerland calls the two fighters together. Dennis Andrews. Now Britain's oldest boxer, revealed only a few days ago that his real age is 38. In fact, he'll be 39 next month. The only British fighter ever to win a world title at the same weight three times. A romantic story of the ring, if ever you've heard one. Marani, the challenger, in the red trunks. The Latin American champion. A touch taller than Andrews. Years ago, Andrews couldn't win the British light heavyweight title. Now he hasn't lost a fight in Britain since 1982. And Marani makes a confident and aggressive start. Peppering the face of Andrews with punches as he goes backwards. Andrews, a man of supreme strength. A man who can come from behind and win. Last few years of Andrews' fighting life have been truly amazing. This is his seventh world title fight. And we have a packed arena here at the Albert Hall tonight. The last time Andrews fought in this arena was as an amateur in 1978 in the London ABA final. And he didn't win that. Well, that's a pretty good start by Marani, who, although he was going backwards, was pushing the punches through the guard of Dennis Andrews. who's been a pro now since 1978. It took him 6 years to win the British title and 8 years to win this World Championship for the first time in 1986. Well, the man who used to hold this WBC title, John Conti, held it from 1974 to 77. He's sitting beside me ringside. What did you make of the opening round, John?
Yeah, I thought he lost the opening round, Dennis, there. But he doesn't look to be too uncomfortable. He seems to be a guy who's very strong, much stronger than his opponent. And the longer the fight goes, the better it will he'll suit him.
Does it amaze you that Andrews has done all the things he's done in the last few years?
Absolutely. His tremendous dedication and fitness and willpower.
Mm-hmm. Would you have liked to have faced him?
Not tonight.
John Conte. So the early points to Morani. Three judges at the ringside scoring. The referee doesn't score. This is only the second time in his life that Morani has fought outside of South America. He made a trip to the United States a few years ago, 87, to Las Vegas, and he met a Nigerian called Jola Sisi, and I'm afraid it only lasted two rounds, and Lasisi won. Morani was born in Tio Cujillo. It's on the back of his trunks, a farming village in the state of Cordoba, the huge central province of Argentina. He still lives on a farm with his parents. Morani, who's got the longer reach, is still pushing those punches through the guard of Andrews. And so far, Andrews has not really made a significant contribution to this fight. Well, it's rather typical of the way Andrews starts many of his fights. A low left hand from Andrews, but on the blind side of the referee. Throws at him, Andrews just walks through it. The sheer brute strength and the will to win of Andrews is what has taken him to the top of the tree late in life. Late in boxing life, that is. And a couple of significant looking punches from Andrews as the bell ended the second round. And Morani looking just slightly disturbed as he goes back to the corner. Morani in his first world title fight. And the same number of fights as he has years. And as I said, only a second fight outside South America. John, what do you make of, you've only had two rounds to look at him, but here's the Argentine. What do you think of him as a fighter?
Well, I think he's good. He's really fulfilling his potential. He's winning ahead. He's won these first two rounds. He's being busy. He's trying to keep out of trouble. He's not as strong as Dennis Andrews. He looks a bit suspect on the wind. He's blowing a bit in the corner. He looks as if he's blowing a bit. So I don't know what his conditioning is. But he's certainly winning the first two rounds.
And the referee is taking Morani back to the corner to wipe some surplus moisture, or grease, I think, Greece over the left eye. They look a little bit concerned about that left eye, and in fact, it does look a little bit red under the eyebrow. Round three. Morani of Argentina. Andres, formerly from Hackney in London, now fights out of Detroit, out of the Kronk stable. Andres lost his world title the first time around to Thomas Hearns, the great Detroit fighter, and he was down six times in that fight, and he was so desperate at the way his career had gone at that point that he actually went to Hearns' manager, Emmanuel Stewart, and said to him, take me on, take me into your stable, I want to learn. And he was, he was then 35 years old, and he started learning all over again. And this is the result, world champion three times. Actually, the fighters in the Kronk stable in Detroit thought they had an easy touch when he came to the gym the first time, knowing what Hearns had done with him. In fact, he proved them all wrong, and he turned out to be the toughest fighter in the gym. Morani trying very hard not to get involved in too many mauls inside, where he knows the strength of Andres will tell. He'd much rather keep it at long range. You saw that clip of Andres beating Jeff Harding in Australia at the top of the program. You only saw the end of it. He was on the end of a bit of a hiding until that dramatic finish came and Andres won. That was when he got the title back and became champion for the third time. And that was only 3 months ago. The pattern very much as it has been in the first two rounds. Although Andres perhaps getting through a little more often now. As John Conte was saying, the Argentine was blowing a bit at the end of the second, and he may already be slowing down. And in fact, he was spitting blood when he went back to the corner. John?
Yeah, I think it was a drawn round I give that. But he looks a bit desperate, Di Morani. He's
desperate already?
Well, yeah, I think so. He's got a bad cut inside his mouth. He's spitting blood. He doesn't look too enthusiastic about this.
And yet, you see, it doesn't appear from here as though Andres has done all that much, but I mean, he's clearly done something.
Yeah, his punches, he's much stronger, and when he does land them, if he can land them, he's powerful punches. He's a big, strong fella. It's like a big ominous presence all the time, you know, over the Morani.
He's getting inside more often now, too. Morani can't keep him down.
Yeah, the strength's telling. But he's also blown a bit, you know, his stamina maybe a bit suspect.
Well, if Morani's stamina is suspect, then he's in for a bad night. Because there's nothing suspect about Andrew's stamina. The Argentine trying to get the left hand to work again. So this for him, he's not looked overawed, and he's tried to carry the fight to Andres from the opening bell. And he may be getting a touch desperate now, but he certainly came into the ring with some determination to get on with it. He hasn't tried to run. Andres has a sort of implacable look about him. Andres comes marching on all the time, and the referees seem to be worried about as though he might have had a cut from Randy there, and I'm not so sure about that left eye. It looked red earlier. I can't see any blood, but the referee was suddenly very worried about it. Ronnie's still getting his punches in, but they're having seemingly very little effect. Actually, this is not a bad round from Ronnie. He's put a lot of good punches together, but he hasn't stopped Andrews marching towards him. Sort of fighter who can break your heart, because it doesn't matter what you do to him, he's still there closing in on you. Yeah, this is a good round for Rani. He's done a lot of work and a lot of scoring. And although Andrews is still coming in, he hasn't really scored too much there, and I would make that a pretty clear round for Morani. Don't know whether John Condy agrees with me.
Yeah, I do, Harry. He certainly won that fight, and he's a tough fighter. He keeps coming back all the time, and although he looks to me as if he's blown, he's not in that such good condition, but he's staying there. He's thrown a lot of punches, he's very busy, he's scoring points, and that's his plan. Dennis's plan is to wear him down, to just let his strength overpower him.
You see, that's the sort of thing Dennis can do, because in that fight recently with Jeff Harding, he was well behind and looking as though he was heading for defeat, when suddenly he brought it all out in the seventh round.
Yeah, well, his pattern of fighting, Dennis, is like just to grind him down, just keep ploughing forward, and so the fight's going exactly the way he plans it at the moment. Just keeps going forward, throwing punches.
They're not coming out for the fifth round. The Rani's corner are signalling retirement, and they're signalling to the referee that Morani has got something wrong with his jaw. It's a suspected broken jaw. Now that in itself, if he's got a broken jaw, that will tell you something about Andrews. Because if he's done that to him without appearing really to work up a sweat, then here is an extraordinarily strong man. But what a disappointing ending to this World Championship fight. Morani having to pull out at the end of four rounds with, I think, a suspected broken jaw, certainly an injured jaw. And Dennis Andrews lifts his arms and has successfully made a first defense of this world title that he's won for the third time. Little bit of an anticlimax, one has to say. But nonetheless, Andrews is the winner, and that's his 38th win in 48 fights. Now then, we might see something here that was significant. That was a good left. And that was the moment when the referee moved in to have a look at Morani. And that might well be the punch, and he certainly is concerned about his jaw. I didn't notice that the first time around, but now seeing it on the replay, I can see that Morani is moving his jaw and putting his hand up to it as though there is something wrong, and the referee saw it as well. So it's quite clear that Morani has got a badly injured jaw and is unable to continue.
At the end of round four, ladies and gentlemen, Morani has retired with a broken jaw, the winner, and still WBC light heavyweight champion of the world, Dennis Andrews.
So Dennis Andrews making a homecoming to Britain after 4 years, successfully defends his WBC light heavyweight title. and once again proves the almost frightening strength that this man has.
Gentlemen, your appreciation, please.
He actually broke a man's jaw without even appearing to really get going. Well, now Dennis Andrews is ready, I think, to talk to our man in the ring, Jim Neely.
Dennis Andrews, many congratulations. I'm quite sure that it wasn't the way that you would have wished to retain your title.
No, but, you know, it's one of those things. You plan to fight a man a certain way, and, you know, you get the opponent who didn't want to fight. He just wanted to throw some scary punches and grab. But I knew gradually the man was going to break up. Within about 8 rounds, I would have knocked him out. But, you know, that's the way it went. But I'm still happy that I won the fight, you know.
Do you remember at what stage that he actually sustained the broken jaw?
His jaw was broken?
That's what they say.
Well, I'm good at doing this kind of thing, but I knew I was gradually wearing him down. He was going to, about 8 rounds when I got to him, but my corner was a bit excited, but I was losing the rounds. I knew I was, you know, he wasn't that much behind, but I was losing the round. But I knew I was going to get him in about 8 rounds.
How difficult an opponent was he?
He was trying to frustrate me, but I was just trying to take my time and just, you know, get to him, just walk him down.
His reach looked pretty good, and I think you found it quite difficult to get to him, especially in the first two or three rounds.
Scary fight. He was just hitting and stepping back, hitting and stepping back.
Let's bring in your trainer, manager, Emmanuel Stewart. Emmanuel, your thoughts, first of all, on that performance by Dennis Andrews.
I give him a C. It was a fair performance. He could do better. You know, I know what he's capable of doing. I thought that even though the guy was what we call fighting a scary type fight, but he would have won the fight if it had continued, possibly. He would throw punches and then grab. But Dennis has got to be.
He's got.
Dennis was breaking him down slowly, but I think he still is going to have to start, whenever a guy throws a punch, to learn to block the punch and throw a punch immediately right away to avoid guys from doing things like that. But it was a fair performance, but he'll be better the next time.
Dennis, what was it like finally fighting here in front of very much your home fans?
It was good. I enjoyed every minute of it. But, you know, I'm just sorry I couldn't do better. But the man wouldn't deny me from doing better. You know, that's the way some fight goes. But I'm not crying. I know I could do better. My manager know I could do better. But we ain't crying. That's the way some things turn out sometimes.
Dennis, well done. Thank you.
Thank you all.